Heard Heidi Heidi back. I got a phone call, interrupted my live stream.
Yeah.
Kind of uncool. I tried to turn it off. Didn't work. Didn't matter. Carrying on. Where are we at? Number three?
Number three.
What's your number three?
My number three is the appetizer. We had a barking frog. Was the foie gras.
Oh, that was good. Yeah. I had a little bite of it. But.
Sitting on top of a bed of organic greens with a little bit of
a terrible driver. Go ahead.
A blue cheese drizzle. It just was melty and buttery and gamey in every bite. I have never experienced something so delicious.
It was real good. Real good. My number three was that barking frog too. Kale and Swiss chard salad. I love vegetables. But it's like they ground it up. The pieces of lettuce were so small.
Shredded, yeah.
Yeah. It just made it a lot easier to eat. Delicious.
Yeah.
Real, real good.
And it was warmed.
Oh, it was warm. Yeah, it was warm. Warm salad.
That was good.
It's a pro move.
Raspberries. Let's see. My number two for food, I'd have to say, would be our room service experiences, just because they were so cozy.
Yeah.
Everything about room service was perfect. The first day I had my standard salmon and capers and bagel.
It's a Mrs. Patch classic.
It is. I love it so much.
It's all the time.
It's so delicious. This time, though, they did it a little different. They added cucumbers.
I've never had cucumbers
with that. And sometimes I add tomato, which I know you hate, but...
Cucumbers are super underrated.
Yeah, that was quite... it was wonderful. And then this morning, I had the... it's called the croque madame. And it's this fancy French thing with brioche and eggs and Gruyere cheese melted over the top. It was just so cozy and comforting, the room service meals.
Room service is always awesome play. My number two was Barking Frog first night. We got a recommendation on wine. Got a bottle of this guy's name is Mark Ryan. Long haul. Real good. We went to that vendor the next day, bought a shit ton of their wine.
That's delicious.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's 10 glasses of wine there.
That's a thing. Which, if you haven't done any wine tasting, like if you watch on Sideways, you know, they take a sip and they pour it out. It's like, ah.
Next.
So, and you can ask for one sampling or two, and it's $10, but if you buy a bottle, it gets waived. So, we got two samplings, each got our own. There's like five wines to try, and you don't get a full glass, obviously, but you get a fair amount.
You get three sips.
And I just drank the whole thing down. Then I saw one guy come in. He looked like a pro. He would take one sip, pour it right out. So I had to do that after a while, just because I knew I had to drive back to the place.
I didn't.
But if you just drink, it was 15 mini
glasses. 15 glasses of wine.
Really, really went for it.
It was great.
What was your number one?
My number one would have to be, in its totality, Herb Farm. That from the minute we walked in the door there to the minute we left.
One is a whole experience.
The whole experience. I mean, we walked in, they had us smelling different herbs. And
yeah,
they were
good.
Crushing herbs so that we could smell all the different things they were going to cook in our food. We passed them all around. And then we were seated with this wonderful group of people. And they had all these really cute personal touches on the table where... made a little framed happy birthday for me in the
caution,
year I was
red
born,
light camera
and a tiara and my napkin and our name on Herb Farm stationery right where we were sitting. And
tons of crazy crap on the walls, all kinds of shit.
We're sitting in there, six wine glasses of all different size and shape in front of us, and these silver goblets for water that they keep refilling and are getting condensation that look like they're glittering and they're beautiful throughout the night. And then all of the staff comes out and introduces themselves and shows us who they are and the wines that we'll be drinking with dinner. And the presentation was all simultaneous. Everyone was plated at the same time and it was all turned in the right direction and everything was a piece of art. You could taste all the different textures and flavors in every bite. There wasn't a single bite that wasn't amazing.
All right, we're not doing a commercial for the herb.
Well, hey, you asked me number one. I'm telling you, it was overwhelmingly number one. It was fantastic in every way. So that's my number one.
Kind of sunk my battleship, but not quite.
Exactly.
Because you're really supposed to pick one item, which I did.
Yeah, and, it's called the top three with an honorable mention. It's really top four.
I think the best item was the elk sausage. Real good.
Yeah, which he stole off my plate.
Yeah,
he totally stabbed my last piece and put the whole thing in your mouth.
Hey, sorry for that.
So
elk sausage was really delicious. Real good. I guess that's about out. All right, I guess that's about it. We're playing Call of Duty. When you play it, you know, when you get the first kill, it's called First Blood, and then every time I get it,
so annoying.
I start singing Blaze of Glory just because it kicks ass. Really, really popular in my house, so.
No.
So enjoy some of it here. Act like you've been there. Well, they tell me that I'm wanted. Yeah, I'm a wanted man. I'm a gold in your stable. I'm a pain. What's your able just to catch me if you can? Here it comes.
I never shoot first, but I do want blood.